Okay, all flight controllers, go, no go for landing. Retro.
Go.
Fido.
Go.
Guidance.
Go.
Control.
Go.
Telcom.
Go.
GNC.
In 1993, NASA announced a project to build the International Space Station. About 5 years later, when they started building the space station, I, a 10-year-old boy, got intrigued by space science. Fast forward all these years, July 2019 marked the 50th anniversary of the historic Apollo 11 mission. And right after that, I got an opportunity to visit the Johnson Space Center in Houston. JSC is popularly known for its flight control functions.
This is Houston. Say again, please.
Houston, we have a problem.
So in this video, I'm going to share my visit to the Johnson Space Center in Houston. As soon as you pull into the parking lot, you're greeted with the giant replica of the Shuttle Independence mounted on a Boeing 747. JSC is a working government building, and they have tram tours that take you to different exhibits. First, we went to the astronaut training facility tour in Building 9, where NASA astronauts train for their current mission.
Astronaut training facility, what you're seeing in front of you, is one of the largest classrooms that we have in use for our scientists, astronauts, and engineers. They're working behind the scenes and inside of these mockups to keep our space program current and moving forward. They're planning and developing new hardware along with training procedures, which will then be used by the astronauts and the ISS mockups you see down below. So those large gray and white objects are mockups of all the modules that make up the ISS. Among these mockups include living quarters, laboratory modules, storage modules, and an airlock that our astronauts can enter and exit through for spacewalks.
Our second tram tour took us to the Orion Mission Control.
This room is called the Orion Mission Control, but its official name is the White Figure, which stands for the White Flight Control Room. NASA controlled about half our space shuttle missions here. This room is no longer an active mission control. Another purpose for this room is that it's also used to train employees to work in the current mission control. They're going to be in here maybe 3 to 4 days out of the work week, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. They're all going to be graduated from college. They all will have degrees in the STEM field. And overall, their training process will take between 2 to 3 years long.
Then we took another tram to visit the iconic Apollo Mission Control Center, from which NASA led Gemini and Apollo missions, including the first lunar landing mission. The main visitor building has tons of amazing artifacts that trace human space exploration. To conclude our visit, we stepped out to the Independence Plaza, where we entered the shuttle replica Independence. JSC features numerous exhibits and attractions. The experience is designed to engage everyone, adults and children. Known as the home of NASA Mission Control, you are literally taken behind the scenes to see how JSC operates. Johnson Space Center does an excellent job of educating and inspiring the public about NASA and the important milestones in American and global space exploration.